Hi, I'm Indra Sahdan Daud. I'm a former national footballer and I've got more than 100 caps for the national team. I got started in football, I think, seriously playing when I was in primary school. You know, I got into St. Andrew's Primary School. And then I just started to play from then. And I think when I was in primary 2, the football coach already brought me up to play with the older boys, which was the primary 3 and primary 4, you know. So basically that's how I started playing football in school in St. Andrew's Primary. I spent 2 years in St. Andrew's Secondary, and then there wasn't a football team after that. So Mr. John Shah called me to join him in St. Gabriel Secondary. So I spent my secondary 4 and my secondary 3 and secondary 4 years in St. Gabriel Secondary. That 1995 Lion City Cup team was amazing, you know. The head coach was Cikgu Sia Sinan, and then we really enjoyed the tournament. Firstly, it's because the tournament itself, we didn't have much trainings. You know, we didn't train at all during the tournament itself. We stayed in the hotel, we played games. The only time when we like really trained was maybe one day before the game. You know, going through all the tactical sides. And then I guess the boys really enjoyed it. You know, we didn't have any pressure. We didn't see it as a tournament. It was just more of like always a friendly game, because the whole year we were just playing a lot of friendly games. So it became like second nature to us. It was just another game. There wasn't any pressure. The boys were like enjoying it. I guess that's why we did well in that tournament.
Young Indra Sahdan coming into the action.
Playing for Geylang United, I guess, was a big thing for many young boys. You know, Geylang was one of the top teams then. I would say I'm very lucky because Mr. Robert Lim, he's the one who brought me into the Geylang setup. Honestly, I didn't really think much about it. I was just thinking maybe I was just making up the numbers. No, because I was only maybe 17 then. But he gave me a lot of opportunity to show myself, you know. And I did quite well at Geylang. And then I'm very happy that I also won the Young Player of the Year award when I was in Geylang. The game against Manchester United in 2001 is one of the games where I don't think I will ever forget. You know, I scored a goal against one of the top European teams, and I think until now people are still asking me like how I feel, you know, scoring a goal against Manchester United. And then I actually really get a kick out of it because I'm a Liverpool fan, you know. So when people ask me like that, I kind of like proud to say that I scored against a Manchester United team, which is for me one of those big achievements throughout my career. The match against Japan in 2004, I can clearly still remember the goal. You know, I received a pass from the midfield, and then I saw one of my teammates, I think should be Syahril Ishak, who did an overlap, you know, and then that drew out some of the defenders. And then being a striker, I was a bit selfish, and then especially in front of the goal and then just outside the box. So I took the initiative to like just cut inside and then took a shot, you know. Like they say, if you don't buy the ticket, you'll never win the lottery, you know. So I just took a shot and the ball just went in. In January 05, we played our second leg of the finals at the National Stadium. You know, it was one of those experiences where I think nobody will forget in the team. We left the hotel, you know, we've got fans at the lobby, outside of the hotel. And then maybe got on the bus. We even had escort, like, you know, fans following the bus to the stadium. Then near the stadium, you could see a lot of people, you know, walking to the stadium, and everybody was wearing red. You know, something that we don't see in the last few years. You know, even players in the bus were really excited. You know, were really amazed at the whole situation. You know, first time we all seeing so many people walking to the stadium, all wearing red. And then when we reached the stadium, it was already full packed. You know, people were like cheering, and then we could see the Kallang Wave. The drums were there. You know, it was like a very loud atmosphere. Something that I will never forget, that experience. Really, even me speaking of it now, you know, I got my the hair on the back of my neck standing up. You know, it was like really amazing atmosphere. We came into the game already winning 3-1. You know, in the first leg we beat Indonesia 3-1 in Indonesia, and then coming the home game, really told us, you know, to really seal the title, we have to get an early goal, and that will like really seal the whole tournament up. And we managed to do that. You know, I still remember Lionel just kicking a long ball, and then I managed to like get behind the defender. And then I guess the ball really bounced nicely in front of me. I took a shot, you know, and then it ended at the bottom corner of the goal. And you can really see here, you know, the fans cheering. The whole stadium was very loud. I couldn't even like hear instructions from the bench, or you know, people calling me. It was a moment to enjoy for me. I played under Coach Reddy from 2003 up to maybe 2009. You know, as a coach, very detailed. You know, even before trainings, he will speak to us what we supposed to do. You know, what the sessions is about, and then during post-match, I mean the pre-match. He would really go into details of how we're going to play and who are the players to watch out from the other team. You know, he has videos of them playing, and then so that way we already have a mental picture of what that player is going to do and how the player is going to like react during certain matches, you know. So it really got the whole team to be very prepared for a match. Yeah, and then one good thing I like is during his time, we never played any of the weak teams. You know, in our friendly, we always played the Middle Eastern teams, the very strong teams. And then all the friendly games that we did, we never did well. We always got trashed by the Middle Eastern team. But I guess that's where one thing is because maybe the mentality of the boys are very strong. You know, that's how we got stronger, and we kept on working. And then so by the time when we came into this tournament, I guess players were mentally very strong, and then we got a bit fitter, you know, we got a bit quicker during like decision making, because we were playing very high quality teams. So I guess that's what helps the whole team. Then one thing I like about Reddy, he's very positive. You know, even during matches where we needed a draw, he will keep on telling the players that even a draw, we need to go and score a goal. You know, so you know, playing football, we like to score goals. You know, we don't like to hear coaches telling us that, oh, we must defend and try to get a 1 point. You know, but for Reddy, it's different. He's always saying that if you want a result, any kind of result, you still need to score a goal. So we were always getting into a game wanting to score goals. Okay, recently I started a personal coaching for kids. Age group is maybe from 10 onwards. Because this coaching session is more into a specific coaching. You know, I've always been a striker since I was very young. So throughout the whole years that I've been playing, I've learned a thing or two from being a centre forward. And then I learned things from maybe Abang Fandi, you know, taught me how to be a good striker. So maybe the reason I started this is because we don't really have a specific coach for strikers at the moment. So that's why I started this, hoping to like have to work with kids who are aspiring to be better players, national players, you know. So maybe with my experience, I can maybe share a thing or two with them. And down the road, maybe if one day I could see one of them playing in the national team, then I'll be very proud. My message to them is, for me, always go beyond. You know, don't be too comfortable where you at. You know, if you go expose yourself or you try and push yourself, you never know where you might end. You know, I mean, yes, it's comfortable just having people around you, people you know, but it will be a good experience, a good achievement for you if you go out of the country, learn a new language, learn a different culture, you know, and you never know where you might end. You know, some people say that sports in Singapore don't go anywhere, you know, but I don't see that way. I always look at the positive side. You know, Singapore has always been looked at from all over the world. You know, small country, but we always have a good reputation. So I don't see why not any of our Singaporeans who really put a lot of effort, you know, their heart and soul into whatever they are achieving, trying to do, sports, be it sports or arts, whatever, you know, they might end up somewhere. Yeah, so for me is, you must always push yourself, push to the limit and see where you end up. Yeah.